Hi everyone, and welcome to our learning series about how to use Figma as a product person. I'm Katie Chambers, and I'm joined by Lauren, who's one of our design advocates on the team and a professional designer herself. She's teaching us how to create things like lightweight prototypes in Figma so that we can visually communicate our ideas, our proposals to our stakeholders to get that all important buy-in. Yesterday, we learned about how to create our file and structure it with the various components you can use in Figma. And today we're gonna start adding to that. We're gonna be adding components that our designers have already created and really just understanding what is a library. When people talk about libraries, how do I get to them? And then how do I pull those into my design so I can not have to start from scratch every time? Lauren, thanks for being here and can't wait for our lesson today. Should we dig in?
Yes, let's do it. Excellent. Okay, so we're gonna pop into a blank file here. We've added in a frame, which we learned how to do last time using the F key and grabbing an iPhone or whatever frame you want from over here. And we're gonna dig now into how to grab from those libraries. So to find your libraries, you're gonna wanna look over here on the left-hand side, specifically in the Assets panel. So you might be starting out in the Layers panel, but you're gonna wanna move over to the Assets panel.
And Lauren, what is a library?
Great question. Yeah, so a library is basically a collection of, it could be components, it could be styles, colors, font styles, it could be now variables. It's a collection of those things that you're going to be able to reuse. So for example, if your designers, usually it's the systems designers who are creating these libraries, if your designers have created a library for components that are like, let's take Figma for example, the Figma UI components are on our Figma website, certain buttons, they've created a library here, you don't have to recreate that button every single time. You can pull from their library and you'll know that it's the right dimensions, it's the right size. And anytime that they update those buttons, those changes will be pushed to you and you'll get a notification so that you can update based on the changes that they made.
That is so powerful and so helpful in understanding what that library is. So it sounds like it's a little toolbox that automatically, magically updates.
Exactly.
Designers update our brand.
Yep.
Love that. Okay. Where do we find those? So, I'm sold. I want to use them.
Perfect. Awesome. So you're going to go into your Assets panel to find them. So we can already see some libraries have been turned on for me. And that means that when I, as a designer, am publishing a library, I'm going to have the option to either publish it to my entire, and again, this is on the enterprise plan. So I'm going to have the option to either publish it to my entire org, everybody in my, we're working in Twigma right now, so everybody in Twigma, or I could publish it to just the team that I'm in, so in the Advocates workspace. I can also, from admin settings, determine if certain libraries are turned on by default. So what that means is we just opened this file and these libraries are already here for us. We don't have to go find them. So if you're working in a specific team where you are always constantly using this X library, you're gonna want that turned on by default. So we can change what is and what isn't turned on. I can also, I don't actually need some of these libraries, so I can also manually turn them off when I'm in my file. So let's get into kind of where we should go. So I love that they use this icon. It's literally a book icon. Makes a lot of sense. Team library, this is where you're going to want to go to turn on and off and find different libraries. So let's pop into there. We get this modal that comes up that says libraries. I can see right now I'm in my, it's saying, this is your current file. This right here is where I would publish my own library. We're not going to publish our own library. And it, right now I actually can't because I don't have any components. I don't have any styles. I don't have any variables created. It's not going to let you publish a library if you don't have any of those things. If I did have those created, I would be able to publish it. We're not going to get into publishing. We're going to get into using. We can see right now, these are the libraries that I have added. These were the ones that were turned on by default. If I don't want those, I can remove them. So if you watch as I remove them, you can watch in my left-hand corner, they're disappearing. So they're not clogging things up. A lot of times you don't need, maybe if you're just working on a personal project or has nothing to do with the libraries that have been turned on by default, you can remove those so they're not clogging things up.
Okay.
But we obviously want to use a library. We want to use, let's say we wanted, let's keep on the Foundations library. And let's also go searching for a library. Say we aren't really finding one with a lot of components, because if we actually just take a look at what's in this library, we have one component. This is not going to help us. So we're going to go back and we're going to go into our team library. And now I'm going to search for libraries. I can either search manually. If you know exactly what you're looking for, I could search for, let's see, I think there's some mobile components.
Mobile,
So this is going to show me all of the options and what's in there too. We can see there's not a ton. Some are having more than others. But now if I go back, I can also just search from the places that I'm in. So this is my team that I'm in, and this is my org that I'm in. So I'm going to search in my org. I'm going to go to Twigma Labs, and I'm going to look.
This is just essentially like browsing what's available.
Exactly. Yep, exactly. Okay. And again, you can't break anything. When you're using somebody else's library, you can't, you're not going to be breaking it right now just by searching for things. Let's add in my mobile components. Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's add in my mobile components. And I'm going to add in my icons too, just because there's 1,000 components in here. This will give us something to play with. So I'm going to add in these.
Don't need the Google icon image.
Yeah, exactly. So you can see they're added because they say added now. And you can see a lot more showed up in my left-hand side over here.
Okay, great.
So I'm going to X out of this. I now have my libraries here. And I can do a couple of different things. I can search manually, like if I know in my icons, I'm not really familiar with what's in here, but I just want to peruse. I can take a look in here and look through the down arrows. And if I want to insert one, I can drag into here. If there are variations of this component, so we're going to talk about components soon, but there might be variations, like say your systems team has created a button, but they have a primary button and a secondary button and a default and a hovered state and all of these states, those are variations of components. If we go ahead and we look for a button, this one, if I hover over this, we can see there's 32 variations. Whoa. If
that's a lot of variation.
Yeah, there's some that'll have many, many a variation.
Wow.
So if I just click, I clicked right on this and this playground appears now. And from here, I can see what are my options. What are the variations of components that I have here? So I can play around and I say I want a CTA here. I want this to actually be my secondary. I do want an icon on, and I want it.
This is so powerful, Lauren.
Yes, and this is actually newer as of a couple of weeks ago. This is very huge. Okay.
And can you tell me the language here? So we're looking at, this is a component that I'm looking at that's in my library.
Exactly.
Okay, and these are properties of the component?
Yep, you're looking, exactly. You're looking, some are component properties, some are variations. Yep, so these are going to be your component variants or component properties in here, exactly.
Variants, okay. Variants, which are different than variables.
Yes, and that is a headache.
I'm learning.
Yes, and I have a...
variants, so when we're talking about different looks and feels of our component, that would be a different variant of that component.
Exactly. Different variation of a component is a variant. Exactly.
Great.
Yep.
Got it.
So from here, I've played around with, oh, what are all my different variants? This is the one that I want to insert. So I can pop this in now. And this now is the different variant. And if I decide from there that, no, actually, I didn't want this one, where I'm going to go to change that is over here on my right-hand side.
Great. Okay.
And I still have all those.
I don't have to paste in a new variant of that. Come on, I can just change it here.
Exactly.
And just to confirm, when I'm changing these to the different variants, that's not changing it for anyone else. It's just changing it for this button that I put into my file.
Exactly. So you're not changing it for anybody else. This is just in your file right now. This is just only for you. You're just playing around with the different variations here.
Awesome. Okay, we are going to dig in lots of components, I think, tomorrow. So we can put a pin in that one. So we talked about in our library, we have all these components. You've also mentioned a couple of times in libraries, we can have styles and variables as well, I think. What would those look like when we're looking at the library?
So, great question. So I'm going to create something that I can add a style to. I'm just going to create a rectangle. And we're going to go over here to these four dots and look at these styles. And here is where I can see all of these pre-created color styles that I can pull from. So really helpful if you have a specific brand guidelines for your, like the colors that you use at your company, you don't have to remember that hex code constantly. You can pull from the styles here and make sure you have the right one.
When we have those styles selected, did we turn those styles on for the colors? Like, how did those get here?
Great question. So that's part of the library. So we can actually see where they're coming from. This one is from the Foundations library. So we have that library turned on. So people might have, some folks create like their colors and their textiles. This is a Foundations library. They create those. That's why there's no components in here. It's really just the colors. Some people create them as they have all their components and all their colors and all their fonts in one library. So let's see if we look, if we keep looking in here, if there's any more, all our libraries. Yeah. So I think Foundations is the only one that has colors right now, but you can, there absolutely might be libraries that are having, that have color styles, that have components, that have text styles, that have variables all in it. It just is dependent upon how your team has set that up.
Okay. And I don't know if this is a silly question, but when we were browsing our libraries, when we're shopping libraries we want to apply, is there a way to see that there are colors and other things in the library?
So let's pop back into here and if I click into here, I just clicked right on foundations. This is going to show me what is involved in this library. I have all of these styles and these components.
Cool.
Yeah. So let's see if we have the mobile components. Yep, you can see there's no styles. It's literally just components here because that's how we break up a lot of our libraries. But you should be able to see what these all look like. You can also, you see this, it says open file. I can go back to, if I want to see where were these all created, I'm now going back to the original file where these were all created. If you want to look at, especially like how we looked at those variants, you could only see one at a time. You can see now this is where they've been created. These are how I see all of them at one time, which can be very helpful to visualize.
That is incredible.
Very handy.
Love this. Okay, and then the last thing you mentioned can be in these libraries are variables.
Yeah, so variables.
Big topic, but like how would it apply in a library?
It would be the same way. So we don't see any variables in our kind of like colors over here. So let's look for a library that has one. I know there's something in our Twigma Enterprise, in our Advocates and Architects. Let's turn on this file. This is showing us that we have variable collections. Excellent. I'm going to add this to the file. Now I'm going to go ahead and pop into here. I'm in Foundations. I'm going to open up the demo shop. We can see it's the only real difference visually is that it's a rectangle as opposed to a circle.
Ah.
You can see if I'm going to put on all libraries here so we can see the two different libraries.
Yes.
So this one's a variable. This one's a style. And just the difference visually of how you know which one you're grabbing versus also this one is not in the little kind of rectangle. When we swap it back to theme, you can see there's a little rectangle behind it. It's in a little home. So that's just the visual difference between a variable and a style when you are pulling those colors in.
Incredible. Well, for the purposes of my work and our objective, I don't think we'll be using variables, but it's helpful to know where they are, what they are, and how they fit into these libraries. And when we see the rectangle versus the circle, that we're looking at a variable versus a style.
Totally.
So thank you. And I think we have covered all of the kind of core things we wanted to go over in libraries.
One last thing that I wanted to go over is just searching in the assets panel, because a lot of times you might even just not even be sure if it exists. Like I feel like a button or like a certain icon, when we added in that icon library, there's over 1,000. You do not want to manually look for that. So searching in the assets panel is the majority of time how I find my assets. So if I search for button, we'll be able to see all the buttons that exist in my libraries. I can narrow it down if I know I only want a button from a mobile component library. That narrows me down to one. I can also do all libraries. And then I can see, what if there's a button that exists in a library that hasn't been turned on? So I can show literally all my results of, wait, I need to actually, now I know, okay, I need to turn on this specific library. So this is going to be really helpful. And like searching for the icons, I would guess there is a heart icon. Let's see. Yep, there's a heart icon there. But then I can see, this is the heart icon I'm looking for. I need to go turn that library on, or I need to go find that library and let's figure out where it's even coming from type of thing. So searching is probably the way that I find assets in my library the most.
That is so powerful.
Yeah.
What a great way to just like, again, Google was my default in the past. Figma will be my default in the future.
Yep.
How do I find things? And then I won't bring all these things in out of brand and have my designers rolling their eyes at me is quite as much. That is a huge power tip. Thank you for that. And I think with that, we've covered everything we wanted to go over with libraries.
Yes.
So you told us about what is a library, how do I find them, how we can have styles, variables, or components in the library. We looked at how you can check out those components and look at the different options you can pull in and then how to switch those later. We talked about how you can view all the libraries available and, more importantly, as you just showed at the end here, how to search for specific things you're looking at and find those to pull those in from the libraries, and then also how to turn them on and off. So with that, I feel much more comfortable talking about libraries and also hopefully using them in our designs as we go. Tomorrow, we'll start pulling in some of those components from our libraries and then start using those to really start creating the shape of our first frame here. Thank you so much, Lauren. Thank you, everyone, for joining us today. And we'll see you next time to talk about components.
Awesome. Thanks, everybody.